I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain.
Hi, I'm Jeanette Fan. I play the cello in Symphonia. I'm going to be attending University of Texas at Dallas for marketing.
Hi, my name is Angelica Sharma. I play the violin and I'm in Symphonia. I am committed to going to the University of Texas at Austin and my major is computer science.
My name is Elias. I'm in the Symphony Orchestra. I play the viola and I just got admitted to Brigham Young University at Provo. I'm open major right now.
Hi, my name is Benita Fasala. I play the violin in the Symphonia Orchestra, and I am not committed to a college yet.
I'm Selena Kaur. I'm in chamber, a violinist, and I plan on going to U of H to be an engineer.
My name is Claire. I play violin in Symphonia, and I will be attending UT Austin, majoring in public health and economics.
Hi, I'm Nicole. I'm a viola in Sinfonietta, and I'm going to University of North Texas to study human development and family sciences.
Hi, I'm Sophia Vargas. I play the violin in Symphonia, and I'm going to be attending UTD for biomedical engineering.
I'm Sana. I'm a violin in the Sinfonietta Orchestra, and I'm going to the University of Pittsburgh to study biology.
Hi, my name is Irene, and I play the violin in Sinfonia Orchestra, and I'm not committed to college.
My name is Amory. I play the cello. I'm in Sinfonia, and I'm going to UT to study economics.
Hi, my name is Christine. I play violin in Symphonia, and I'll be going to Rice University to study biochem.
My name is Zainab. I'm in chamber. I'm a violinist, and I'm going to go to University of Houston and major in computer science.
My name is Arthur. I play the cello. I'm in Symphonia, and I'm going to U of H. I'm not sure what I'm majoring in.
I'm Sophia. I'm a violinist in Sinfonietta, and I still have not decided where I'm going.
Hi, my name is Daniel. I play violin in the Symphony Orchestra, and I will also be attending UT Dallas. My major is business.
My name is Ethan. I play the cello. I'm in Symphonia, and I'm going to UNT to study music composition and cello performance.
How has your orchestra experience shaped you as a person?
Honestly, I think for me, it's like calmed me down. Like every time I get into orchestra, like I like start the day and I'm going crazy, and then I get to orchestra, like I play, and I'm like, oh, I'm okay. Like I chill out.
Orchestra has taught me how to work in a team with other people.
I feel like orchestra really helped me like bond with people. Like it taught me how to be, I guess, more social.
I think it's made me more of an attentive person.
Well, honestly, a lot of my closest friends have all been people that I've met through orchestra.
I'd say it definitely taught me to just be authentic and true to myself.
Orchestra definitely helped me develop thick skin because we do like solo and ensemble and a bunch of other competitions, so it's like helpful to deal with the nerves.
I've definitely had to adjust, get out of my comfort zone a little bit, and I think it's always been a place of comfort for me. I've had a lot of personal struggles, especially this year, so having a place where I can just come, like play music, be with my friends has always been really comforting for me.
I learned a lot of things from orchestra. I've learned a lot of teamwork, gained a lot of friends. It's been a good 4 years for me. I'm glad like I didn't quit or anything.
Socializing is like a really big aspect of it, because even though it is like an individual thing where you each play like your own instruments and everything, you're all working together as a team, but you're all individually contributing. It's really taught me how to do my part in the team.
It more or less kind of put me in a situation where I had to kind of communicate. If not verbally, then I guess it helped me like with my body language, being able to communicate with other people, because you kind of have to do that in orchestra where everyone has to basically communicate with each other in order for everything to work.
What is your favorite orchestra memory?
I actually have two. My first one was winning us when we went to Orlando. And then my second favorite memory was playing in the Pit Orchestra for Phantom for the opera.
At the end, Ethan got kind of sentimental. About
how well
the cellos.
Oh, yeah. My favorite memory was when we won at Asta.
Yeah, me too. My freshman year, when we got to play full symphony orchestra, and I just really liked the music from that year. And it was really fun just like having pretty hard music where you had to actually practice, and it sounded good with Ben.
Oh, yeah. That one time for the winter social when we did karaoke, it was just, I like singing, so.
I would say TMEA. It was Benita's first time away from home, so we were just having like a complete blast. It was a lot of fun. It was a really nice performance, and so I really enjoyed that whole experience.
Definitely hanging out with my friends before rehearsals and everything.
Whenever I did Pit my sophomore year, and we were doing Big Fish, one of those rehearsals where you ran through the whole thing, and someone was mic'd up, and me and Ethan were sitting in the pit, and we were just like waiting, and someone went to go pee, and their mic was still on. So it was like in the pack, and they were just peeing, fully blasted in the pack.
For us, it's definitely freshman year, we went on the Dallas trip. Yeah, that was like a highlight of my high school years, to be honest.
It was really funny. It was so chaotic. It was
like, what's your favorite Nelson quote?
Oh, I got this. I like the one where he's like, do you guys have siblings? Use your bow so you hit your siblings. Because you guys hate your siblings, right? Bend your bow and make sure you hit your siblings.
Don't play to lose, play to win.
My favorite quote has always been the grapefruit one. You gotta squeeze out the tone like you're squeezing all the juices from a grapefruit.
Squeeze the grapefruit.
Grapefruit. Whenever the orchestra group isn't being very good with how they can serve the bow, Mr. Nelson will tell us, hey, you know, just like those grapefruit leather, like, squeeze the last drop out of every grapefruit.
Treat that note like you treat your mom.
More to life than like class
records. One time on Zoom, Mr. Nelson DM'd everyone all the cellos in chat. He was like, are you breaking a sweat? Do your elbows hurt or something like that?
It was in all caps.
Yeah.
It was in all caps.
Whenever someone's like taking a long time to get ready, he'll be like, oh, you owe me Starbucks or something. But this year he changed it from Starbucks to boba
tea.
He's also like, if you do this, I'll get you Dr. Pepper.
No. Make it sound like a big blue bird flying across the horizon, but not any bird, a fat bird. And at home I asked him what he meant by that and he said, I don't know.
What's your favorite funny moment in orchestra?
I just like it when Ho Young answers the questions with the bluntest voice ever. That actually makes me crack up so much.
I think it's funny when the directors like say something or they ask a question and it's silent. That's what I was gonna say.
Bashir ordering broccoli and putting half of the hot sauce.
No, he ordered dessert, but they gave him broccoli. Yeah.
At TMEA, on our way back at the bus ride, when we were all playing on toy instruments and playing Jingle Bell, or it was a sleigh ride, That was my favorite memory, it was really funny.
It was when Mr. Nelson said, like, my pockets are empty. You know the pocket, like, innards, like, the white part? He, like, pulled it out completely. Like, his keys and, like, his wallet and stuff. He just, like, pulled them out and left them on the stand.
You forgot that I have no money. Oh, yeah. Alan was, like, sitting, like, right outside of Mr. Nelson's office. Mr. Nelson came out, and he took a chair, and he, like, threw it, like, on the ground, and it almost hit Alan's face. And, like, everybody just burst out laughing.
We were at Bubba Gum, and Bashir, he kept asking the waiters for key lime pie. and then he ended up getting a bowl of broccoli.
And the hot sauce.
Yeah. It was, like, a new hot sauce bottle, and he ate, like, more than half of the hot sauce itself.
What are some unwritten rules in orchestra?
Wear a jacket to class.
If Mr. Nelson says something, no one talks. You know, I feel like that's kind of the pattern that I've seen throughout pretty much all of my 4 years of being in high school. Just say something, all right? It's really awkward. Okay, that's just my honest opinion on it.
Where you put your instrument on the first day, that's like your spot. So you just stay there for the rest of the year. You can't take someone else's unpacking spot. If you do that, you're our menace.
You cannot use the restroom during orchestra class. You have to train your body to either go before or after class. I am so scared of asking Mr. Nelson to use the restroom. I think I've only gone during orchestra class like maybe once or twice.
Don't talk.
That's not true. Everyone
Nobody
talks.
It's silent. Except Bashir.
That's true.
It's not a rule, but like we just don't answer him. like our orchestra just like likes to just stare at him. I guess it's a rule between us, but like everybody should just stare at him for some reason. Yeah, there's two people that answer in the orchestra and Ho Young and Elias.
We're just awkward.
Oh, you unpack in the same place that you did in the beginning of the year. I'm an honorary viola because there's not enough space in the violin.
Don't be late. Always be ready and on time.
We're always late.
If you were to be stuck on a stranded island with one of the directors, who would it be and why?
I think I would like to be stuck with Vera. I feel like Vera knows how to survive because he plays video games.
Nelson would get you off the island first and Vera would just like have a good time. So I feel like I would not survive, so I would say Nelson.
Probably Vera.
No reason. I'm just throwing it out there.
Mr. Vera would make you feel very comfortable there.
No, Mr. Vera would be like, yes. He'd be like, it's gonna be okay.
Mr. Ness would just start building the boat.
He'd just start going.
Probably Mr. Vera. He's just a lot funnier, I feel like.
We can relate to him a lot. He talks to us a lot, and it feels like you're talking to a friend, honestly, Mr. Vera.
Nelson, I think he has life skill.
Mr. Vera, because he's not as intimidating, and he actually looks like he would know how to survive in a situation like that. Mr. Vera's gonna whip out his Nintendo Switch and stuff.
By myself.
Honestly, yeah.
I would say Mr. Nelson, because I feel like he has a lot of random life skills.
Yeah, I would say Mr. Nelson as well.
I think I would actually stick with Mr. Oscar Vera as well.
I don't know, I feel like he was like a Boy Scout or something.
Honestly, I'd stick with Mr. Vera. He knows too many things.
If you could compare Mr. Nelson or Mr. Vera to an animal, what would they be and why?
I would say he's like a dog because he's super friendly. He's always been kind of like a friend, especially during lunch. Like, we've always had the most casual conversations together.
Mr. Vera, I compare to a manatee because he's pretty docile. He's very, very chill.
I feel like Mr. Vera would be a cat.
Turtle.
What's a very like calm but like
a chill animal?
I think he can be either an owl or a cat.
A cat.
He loves cats. But in the context of our class, he's more of an owl though. He's always in the back just looking. And it's the scariest thing ever. Especially if you're put towards the back, you have more pressure of him roasting you so bad.
An owl in my opinion. An owl? Maybe it's because he's a cat person. I think a Mr. Vera is a very scruffy cat.
You know that like whack-a-mole game where it's like things like pop out? He's similar to one of those because he just randomly like pops out sometime, like makes a comment.
Mr. Vera is like an echidna.
Mr. Nelson's a lynx.
What?
You sound like you thought about this before. Yeah.
He's cutthroat in a good way.
Maybe Mr. Nelson looks like a little parrot.
Mr. Nelson is kind of like my dog. He's fairly unpredictable, but I think he's very helpful. Not in the way that my dog is, but still helpful nonetheless.
I think for Mr. Nelson, I would pick an owl because he's really wise. He literally has a lot of knowledge. It's pretty cool.
Mr. Nelson is definitely a grizzly bear, 100%.
I would say Mr. Nelson's an ostrich. When he gets mad at us, like, I can just imagine, like, an ostrich angrily, like, squawking. Like, it's ostrich vibes.
Can you make an ostrich sound?
Do you even make a sound?
What is the sound?
I guess a koala, maybe?
A koala?
Yeah. I would compare him to a lion.
A shark. His gaze, when he's just like staring at you, reminds me of Bruce from Finding Nemo.
Do you have any advice for underclassmen regarding orchestra?
If you can, stick with it all 4 years. Cause you make a lot of memories, even though it might not seem like it, especially if you're in your first year. But you meet a lot of people, and usually the people that you meet in orchestra are the people you stick around with the most.
You choose what kind of experience you have in orchestra. You're the person who makes that decision, who takes that step to get out there. That's something that I kind of wish I'd done a little bit more, been a little bit more proactive. So I encourage you to do that, you know, as soon as possible. Just try and get yourself out there. Even if you get embarrassed, just do it again, keep going. Because in the end, it's gonna be worth it.
Definitely don't quit. Orchestra teaches you so many things, like, you know, teamwork, leadership, you know, discipline, responsibility, and of course, getting better as a musician. And so there's something for you in this program, whether it be, you know, music, whether it be friends, whether it be social. So I would just focus on that one thing and stick with it, and you'll find you'll have a lot better experience than if you just look at it from the glasses half empty.
Like, don't play for a specific chair quiz or to get into a specific orchestra or whatever. Just play for yourself, because that's what's most important.
Definitely don't quit. It doesn't, like Christine said, it doesn't tank your GPA that much, so.
Salutorian!
Remember, GPA exempt exists, if you're really that worried.
Take it all 4 years, because honestly, it's very much worth it.
I think it's worth it. Like, the friends and the memories that you make are honestly a lot of fun.
Like, I can't imagine not doing it. It's just such a big part of my life.
Also, practice.
Like, I know everyone says that, but it really is the way you become good at it.
Don't be bad.
go on the trips and stuff, because I kind of regret not going on some of the trips that were like the yearly trips, because you get to like spend time with people and make bonds with people.
Be proactive, go to socials, make friends with people in your orchestra, outside of your orchestra, because I feel like if you don't, you don't really truly get the full orchestra experience and you just won't enjoy it as much.
I would say that orchestra doesn't tank your GPA as much as you think it does.
Also guys, this is valedictorian right here, so.
Yeah!
We're gonna do some senior hot takes. So you're gonna answer the following questions with a senior that meets the description.
Who is most likely to fall asleep during class?
Irene literally sleeps in class. Irene sleeps in class, I've seen her.
I'd say Arthur.
Why do you want to say me?
I want to say you too.
Irene.
Who's most likely to break their instrument?
I would say myself, because I chipped my instrument.
Irene.
I've heard Arthur a lot. I feel like he's kind of, I mean, I love Arthur, but like he's kind of clumsy.
I feel like doing that one.
I feel like I would. I've taken like chunks out of my cello just from like hitting my bow.
Irene
is just in the corner over there.
Loki, I think Arthur. I was gonna say Arthur. I don't know why. Oh, he's standing outside.
Sorry, Arthur.
Who's most likely to become famous?
Oh my god.
TikTok famous.
Jeanette.
Successful, I think.
Christine
or Angelica.
Yeah.
Christine.
Yeah.
Christine.
You're like Angelica. Yeah, she would
be like a famous like
scientist
of some kind.
Yeah. Oh, Ethan.
Christine.
I'll just say Christine.
Christine. My
boy, Christine.
Dude, Christine is too strong. She's a girl
boss.
Who's the most
prepared during rehearsals? Ethan.
Ethan.
I would say Elias.
Elias or Ethan?
Elias.
I would say Elias too.
Say no.
Nicole.
Yeah.
No one.
I guess Ethan, because he's Mr. Nelson's kid, so I mean, he knows everything.
Ethan Alexander Nelson. Yeah. He's standing right outside right now.
Say hi, Ethan. Last one. Who'd be the best stand partner?
Me.
Benita would just ask me what the time is.
I would probably say Jeanette. Definitely not Benita.
Only
the second violin.
Benita.
Oh, you.
Yeah. Only you, Jeanette.
Me?
I think you're the only person here that I've been stand partners with for a long time.
I would say Jeanette too.
Me and Sophie have been stand partners all year.
In the back.
Christine.
Okay, so if Hoyoung was a senior, definitely.
Hoyoung's not a senior.
Okay, but.
I feel like Benita.
And that's it.
All right.
Thank you, Elias.